बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। अस्सलामु अलैकुम एंड वेलकम टू ऑल ऑफ यू इन कैंप बूस्टर विद डियर शहजादी। आई वेलकम टू ऑल ऑफ यू विद द न्यू टॉपिक ऑफ द सेकंड चैप्टर, दैट इज द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द एटम। इन दिस चैप्टर वी आर बेसिकली स्टार्टिंग द थीरीज एंड द एक्सपेरिमेंट दैट वर परफॉर्म्ड बाय द साइंटिस्ट टू डिस्कवर द सब एटॉमिक पार्टिकल्स, दैट वॉज द फर्दर इलेक्ट्रॉन, प्रोटॉन एंड द न्यूट्रॉन। In this lecture, we are trying to study about the discovery of the proton that are the basically positively charged. We all know that after the discovery of the electron, that was basically the cathode rays originated, and these were negatively charged particles, and the scientists tried their best to experiment and perform the various type of the experiments to further qualify or further subdivide the atom, structure of the atom. Atom was divided justly only that of one part, and the structure atom of the structure is furtherly worst. It has the variety of the subatomic particles like the electron, proton and the neutron. But still towards the 19th century, there was just only discovered the electrons, that was basically called the cathode rays, and scientists start their work towards the discovery of the other thing, that was And in the 1886, Goldstein discovered that in the cathode ray, there was not a cathode ray only. In the discharge tube of the experiment, there was an other ray that was moving oppositely charged, and they were also moving in opposite direction towards the cathode rays. That was the protons and the positively charged ion, and these were the protons. But he performed and he set up his own way to discover the protons. He was using the same setup for the discovery of the proton. He was using the high charge battery, high voltage battery, that was connected towards the two anodes or the two electrodes of the that was placed inside the glass tube of the discharge tube, with the positive and the negative terminals of the batteries and the anode and the electrode and the anode. Electrodes were connected towards the positive and the negative terminal of the battery, and here he used a perforated cathode. Anode plate was a plain plate and the cathode plate was a perforated because it was a porous. He wants to show that there was a something that will just pass away from these pores and will strike at the structure or the wall of the discharge tube and will produce the shine that is majorly different, totally different from the shine of the last previous experiment that was performed for the production of the cathode ray. And this experiment was also kept in the very low pressure, that was 10⁻⁴ atmospheric pressure, and the result of this experiment was that here was definitely a positively charged particles that was pass from the pore structure of the cathode perforated electrode and strike the wall of the cathode rays, glassware, and produce the red type or the red sense of the glow. That was the major discovery of the Goldstein about the production of the proton. Moves towards the canal rays and how it was converted into the canal rays, because these were producing from the anode and passing from the cathode rays, so that's why these were named as the canal rays in 1886. Okay, there are the further properties of the canal rays. These rays travel in the straight line in the direction opposite to the cathode rays because they are also moving in perpendicular to the anode rays, but these are moving in opposite direction to the cathode rays. Their deflection in electric and the magnetic field proves that these are the positively charged, and the nature of the canal ions also depend on the nature of a gas that is present in the discharge tube. This is the new thing that was invented, that in the production of the cathode ray there was no effect on the gas or the discharge tube gas that is used in the discharge tube on the production of the cathode rays. But because we know that the electrons were or the cathode rays were negatively charged because they were the negative electrons, and canal rays are basically the producing from the Positively charged ions, they may be alpha ions or the beta particles, but alpha particles are always positively charged ions, and these ions were the positively, and they the nature of their production was depend upon the nature of the gas that is used in the discharge tube, and they get ionized when they collide or the electrons or the neutron. When the metal is strike with the electrons, they will emit the positive metal ion, that is the called the electrode. The mass of this particle was found equal to that of the proton and the simply multiply of it. The mass of a proton is 1840 times more than the type or the mass of the. These rays were made up of the positively charged particles, and the mass or the charge of the particle depend upon the nature of the gas that is used in the discharge tube, and the different gases produce the different type of the positive rays having the different masses and the different charge. The particle produced by a gas will be the same type of the positive rays produced by the lightest gas, that is a hydrogen containing the. Now moves towards the last discovery of the atom, that was the discovery of the neutrons. Rutherford observed that the atomic mass of the element could be explained on the basis of the masses of the electrons and the proton only, but he was not a right way to discover the mass of the electron and the basis of the proton. But here was in 1920, some neutral particle having the same mass or the equal mass that of the proton must present in the structure of an atom. The scientists were in search how much to search a such particle, neutral particles. Eventually in 1932, Chadwick discovered the neutrons when he bombarded the alpha particles on the beryllium target. He observed the heli penetrating radiations were produced. These radiations were called the neutrons. Basically, these neutrons were beryllium is bombarded with the alpha particles that was producing the carbon and a neutral structure that was the neutron. Here are the few properties of the neutrons. Properties of the neutrons were following. Neutrons carry no charge because they are the neutral. They are heli penetrating, and the mass of these particles were nearly equal to the mass of a proton. Because these are neutral, but they have the mass according to the equal towards the mass of the proton. Here is a graphically the production of the neutron. When the alpha particles strike on a beryllium particle, they will produce the neutron, and the neutron paraffin wax is a pattern that was used, and they will produce further the protons. They were equally in the mass towards the proton. Here is a question for our test. Here is to just draw the label diagram of the canal ray and the discovery of the proton. Properties of the neutron and the properties of also proton. Take care of yourself and others. Have a good day. Allah.